Now, Surah 24, Ayah 58. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ليستأذنكم الذين ملكت أيمانكم والذين لم يبلغوا الحلم منكم ثلاث مرات من قبل صلاة الفجر وحين تدعون ثيابكم من الظهيرة ومن بعد صلاة العشاء ثلاث عورات لكم ليس عليكم ولا عليهم جناح بعدهن طوافون عليكم بعضكم على بعض كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات والله عليم حكيم. O you who believe, those whom your right hand possesses, and those amongst you who have not reached puberty, ask permission from you three times before Fajr, dawn prayer, and in the afternoon when you take off your garments or clothes, and after the Isha night prayer, three times of pudendum genitals for you. Apart from these timings, there is no fault on you or on them that you move about to one another. Likewise, Allah clarifies ayat, signs for you, and Allah is knowing wise. In this ayat, Allah is telling the believers that I was telling you not to enter the room. The adults, now that if you are living in a house and where children are there, so they should ask permission from you while entering in that premises where you are. And this is before the Fajr prayer. And in the afternoon, that is between Zuhr and Asr. And it's not mentioned Zuhr Asr, but I'm telling you the afternoon. And then there is after Isha prayers. These are the three timings of your pudendum or relation for sex, for husband and wife. So you take off your clothes. Now in this ayah, you will note the Arabic word thiyabakum. The word in the beginning I told you, thawb, thiyab, clothes. You take off your clothes. All the time I was reading this ayah, there was not anywhere the word thayab came, thawb came. Here the clothes came. So there is a time when you can take off your clothes for a specific reason. If you want to have, if you are a married man and woman, husband-wife relationship, you want to have husband-wife relationship sexually, then you can have this. These are the timings mentioned to you for that particular time. This time is also mentioned for the men and women. Not that you just take off your clothes for nothing. You may take off your clothes for this particular act or aspect if you are a married man and woman. So now, these are the timings mentioned in the Quran. These are also like prayer timings they are asking. This timing is also given for you to take off your clothes. That means all the time men and women are wearing clothes. That means they are already covered. Taking off your clothes is particular time, that means you are covered all the time. So there you are almost all the time in hijab. You are hiding your private parts all the time. Except for these three timings, if you intend to have that relation with your husband and wife. So now the question is, you must understand what we are reading. That is why the word thayab came here, the clothes. In the beginning I read to you this verse. Thawb, thayab, explain. Thawb means clothes, thayab means clothes. And libas means to wear the clothes. So the permission is allowed only for children. They should ask permission. And even the male servants is in the house, or malakat aymanuk, if you have got right hand position, they are also in the house working. They will also have to ask permission. That means they are in the house working. Women are also there. Yusuf al-Islam was the adopted son by a lady in the house. They can work inside in the house. What I'm saying is, in the premises of women, men and women are there, the children are there, even the right hand possessive men and women are in the house. So they should ask permission. Specific timings are mentioned. Other than these timings, they can move about. Apart from these timings, there is no fault on you or on them that they can move about to another, meaning they can move about without asking permission. They can come where your premises are, because you are dressed up, meaning you are wearing your clothes.
Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.